Infrastructure as code is an awesome way to help automatically provision, deploy, and manage, whether it's just a couple virtual machines or an entire network environment, in a declarative way. Typically, you see this best done with Terraform. And I'll admit, hey, I don't think I even have any videos on Terraform other than hacking it, breaking it, doing some stuff in some strange misconfigurations. But honestly, we use Terraform. I use Terraform to help put together the entire NomCon Capture the Flag competition. Or any CTFs that I host, we build this all out as infrastructure as code. So it's written down, it's established, and super easy to streamline and automate. And maybe one of the coolest things about Terraform is just how easily it is extensible. Like if you wanted to, you could get or add, create, even build your own, right? Terraform providers for anything else, anything that you might be able to hook up some APIs to and have it do what you would like. Normally, you see this used in the case of the big three cloud hosting providers, things like Google Cloud Platform, whether it's Microsoft Azure or AWS, Amazon Web Services, AWS. So what I would like to do in this video is show you just how easy it is, hey, slapping together some syntax, putting together some code to automate deploying some AWS resources. Aside from the initial setup, hey, getting keys and configuration put in place, you really never have to go into the AWS user interface anymore. So I'm inside of a Linux virtual machine. I am just running Kali Linux as usual, but say I want to download Terraform. Now this brings me into the documentation, but ultimately it says, oh, you know what? If you want to go download and install Terraform, you can do this super duper easy. We have this macOS package manager syntax if we'd like, binaries for Windows if we'd like, but I am over on Linux. You could copy and paste these commands and just add it into, I believe, your repository package manager setup. Or we could just grab the binary. If we wanted to download the real thing, I'm good with getting that AMD 64 version. Now over on Kali Linux, let me hit Ctrl-Alt-T to open up a terminal. I'll hit F11 to full screen that, and I'm gonna change directory actually just into my opt folder. I like to work in here for just other tools that I might add, hey, things that I just want to put into that operating system. So let me go grab from my downloads the terraform.zip file that we just downloaded. I can bring that into the current directory with the period and simply unzip that with Terraform. Now this is pretty easy. It just gives us this file for Terraform. And if I were to run the file command on that, just to get an idea, it's the binary itself. That's all it is. It's just an executable binary. I could make sure it is executable. I believe it might already be with that. Whoops. Let me make sure I do that on actual Terraform, not the zip file. We'll minus X that one. And I could just simply run that Terraform binary, ./ from my current directory, and take a look. Here's all the help, all the things we can do, subcommands we could work with. Ultimately, we'll need to do some simple ones. Init, validate, plan, apply, and destroy. We can keep invoking Terraform just like this out of the current directory with the ./ and a relative path if we'd like to, but it might be more worthwhile to add this into your current whole system path. That environment variable, we could go ahead and export that, say, look, search for binaries in these given locations separated by a colon. I'll use the $ there to retain the original value of that variable and then add in our op directory. You could put this in your bash rc file or your .zsh rc file, whatever you'd like, but look, let me make sure to actually do that. Now, even in that directory, I should be able to simply run Terraform, and you will see all that help output one more time. Now, I don't need to ./ it. I can run it anywhere on my file system. Now, with that all set up, back over in the documentation, we should be able to see, scrolling down, hey, all the other things it can run on, and then a couple next steps. There are tons of resources, tons of tutorials and documentation out on Terraform, but look, super duper easy. We could go ahead and spin up some infrastructure as code in AWS. We've already installed Terraform, so we don't need to worry about some of those, but if we wanted to build infrastructure, hey, we could even watch a video. If anyone is interested, seriously recommend you go take a look at these. And if I were to try and speed run us here, look, first thing we'd want to do is probably spit together an EC2 instance, or like a cloud virtual machine within AWS. From the GUI, you'd normally just navigate over to that EC2 instance. Hey, go ahead and say, I want to launch a new box. You could work with all the things here, but honestly, we don't need to do that. We'll have Terraform do it for us. But first, we need to give it some keys, some configuration, so that it's able to connect to our AWS account. One of the easiest ways to set up that connection and communication is with the AWS CLI, or the command line interface. If you don't have that installed on Linux, it is pretty easy. You can just pip install AWS CLI. That should put it all together there for you, and I could go ahead and run AWS, just as the command line interface to get us cruising. First thing you really want to do is AWS configure. That would ask for your AWS access key, maybe none as a placeholder if you didn't already have that configured, your secret key, default region name, and then whatever output format you might prefer. JSON works just fine. So we could cruise through that, entering things as they're needed. In this case, I do already have those configured, but if you want, if you haven't set that up before, you can find those and create some security credentials for yourself, clicking on the top right for your name and the security credentials page. Another option is, hey, putting that together in an IA role, a little bit more access control, better than just a giant root, you know, root user key. So now that we have Terraform installed, we have AWS CLI set up and some of the connections configured, we could really just let Terraform work off of that and go ahead and create our infrastructure as code. So what we'll need to do is open up a text editor, like Sublime Text that I like to use, and we could call something a mainfile.tf, that file extension for Terraform. If you are using Sublime Text, you can go ahead and install a package for Terraform, in case that's worthwhile for you for Terraform format, the FMT subcommand you could run, or even just simple syntax highlighting, worth getting that spun up. Now, first things first is we'll need to specify the provider that we want to use. Remember, this could be using and, hey, hooking up Terraform to the Google Cloud platform or Azure or anything else really, but we're using it for AWS. So we'll provide the syntax, provider, and AWS is what we'll include in strings here. Now, Terraform is really big on this block structure, where we're using these curly braces to define, hey, some of the parameters, some of the variables and things that you'll actually configure and set for any of these blocks. In this case, you might include some of the credentials, like access variables you could use to work with that provider, but because AWS CLI is handling that for us, all we really need to provide here is the region that we want to work in. In my case, I'm going to be working in US West 2. Then in Terraform, we'll go ahead and create all the different resources. Now you might have a ton of these. In fact, you could spread them out across multiple different .tf files, but let's specify that syntax resource and then the kind of resource that we want to create. Since we pulled in this AWS provider, we could actually work with an AWS underscore instance. Then we'll set up the name that we might like. This can be like an example or our VM, whatever. And again, we'll define another block structure. And what we need to define here inside of that resource block is pretty easy for an AWS instance. First of all, we need to say the instance type, like what kind of size, hey, how big, how many resources, and what sort of classification of resources are we setting up this box to be using. So in this case, I'll just keep it simple. T2.micro is usually, I think, a pretty tiny, safe size. And then we'll also need to specify the AMI, or the Amazon machine image, like the kind of ISO, really, and maybe a whole other world we can compare that to, paralleling it to, look, what operating system do you want? What image, what genuine, like, base setup structure operating system do you want for this EC2 instance? Now, we'll need to supply the actual ID for that AMI. So we need to go track it down. We could find them online, especially using AWS as sort of our map and compass here. But that is something that we need to go choose. If I were to get back to AWS, again, navigating the GUI for a little bit, just to kind of get our bearings for us, if we wanted to go, hey, check out the EC2 section, scrolling over to the images, we do have AMIs that either we've set up, configured for ourselves, or the whole AMI catalog. If we want to go track down and find some that are available for us, we could filter on things like, oh, well, do we only want Windows, or do we only want Linux? Is it free? Is it something that actually is behind whatever, I don't know, money, price tag, coin in the mix? But look, let's go choose a 64-bit AWS AMI image, and I'm fine with just using Ubuntu here. Like, if I click this button to select, I know my face is in the way, but that'll bring it up to the top here, and now we'll be able to see, hey, the selected AMI has this actual ID value. So we'll include this for Terraform. Get back over to Sublime Text, we'll just slap that in. Now we can move that just a little bit. So for one thing, you see the full syntax, and because I want to add some other tags. Now this is an interesting one that should be a block set, sort of again using these curly braces, but now we'll be able to define more of these sort of like variables or properties all encapsulated in the logic group there. So the tags in this case, well, I'll just say the name that I want for that EC2 instance, that AWS entity that I've created, we can just call that like example. And let me say, this isn't a secret by any means. Again, if you're willing to go take a look online at the documentation, you could see this exact same setup, this exact same structure, all the same syntax, and a little bit of a better explanation as to the different logic concepts here, like a block, like a provider, like resources. Again, I hope this video can be a springboard for you, but seriously, 1000%, go take a look at the documentation. Now I know this is a super tiny bare bones and basic example, but with this, we're pretty much done. Now we just let Terraform do it, spin it up and create all the things. There's not a lot that's gonna spin up in this case, but we do need to Terraform init or initialize things so it'll go grab that provider. In this case, AWS should all be set up and pretty easy to stage. Terraform will always give you this nice and pretty, hey, green output looking like things are good. I appreciate the use of good color in that. Now, we could really plan and at least get a baseline idea as to what Terraform will create for us. Since this is working with like real infrastructure, it's probably pretty good to get that idea ahead of time. Like, hey, plan, review, actually validate that everything you're either building or destroying in some cases is actually what you want it to be. So with that, we'll just Terraform plan. It takes a little bit, but that will then showcase all the things that Terraform will do for us. Take a look. This includes all of the data, everything set here, and hey, stuff that will be figured out after it's all built, like the IP address that's created, like, oh, any other specific information about the virtual machine. But ultimately, our VM, that instance, will be created, thanks to Terraform. Now, to tell Terraform to just shut up and do it, actually build all the stuff that we've set up, structured, declared, and defined with our infrastructure as code, is simply one command here, Terraform apply. And this will present us with all the same output that Terraform plan did, but now actually validate, look, do you want to do this? Are you sure you want to perform these actions? In this case, we'll enter yes, and then we'll start to spin stuff up. It'll create our VM, that AWS instance, the resource that we set and structured in that main.tf Terraform file. This is pretty cool, actually. In fact, if we were to open up another terminal, let me show you some of the stuff that it did here, because terraform.tfstate, we never created that file. Terraform did. In fact, that's how it was planning everything that it would be willing to do. In our case, let me do a Terraform show. And because we'd already planned things out, it'll be able to, hey, pull up and see everything that it intended on doing. Now, in this case, it created it, created those resources, and it shows us everything that might have came to life there. Everything, including the private IP address, the subnet that it chose, anything specific to like a public IP address, all the details that came from spinning up our virtual machine automatically with Terraform. Now I could hop back over to AWS if I did want to go see the EC2 dashboard. Am I in the right, I might need a refresh. Let me hit F5. There we go, instance is running. We do have one up and available for us, and that is our example. They've got a public IP address, a private IP address, and everything is set. If we wanted to, we could try to connect to it, but we didn't really stage anything with port 22 or SSH or the EC2 instance connect thing. So if I were to even try to, let me see if I can connect to that. I don't know if it'll come to life for us, but this is usually a fine conversation to have because you don't really want to have, I don't know, RDP, especially in the Windows world, public and exposed to the open internet. A lot of the access of services that you might need if you're building this out for your own home lab environment or for a company, for an environment, for a business, for some real network infrastructure, it's ideal for that stuff to be behind a little bit of gates and walls, right? In the Linux world, SSH or the secure shell is an option, right? Hey, if you set that up with the public and private key pairing, then you're at least somewhat secure, but you've still got that open and exposed to the whole open internet. And since we've been working with Terraform, and like I mentioned at the start, Terraform is easily extensible. You could hook up to any other kinds of providers. There is one awesome provider and hey, solution out there called TwinGate. And that helps you roll out access controls like, oh, what can actually connect and access what? You can define that across multiple environments and multi-cloud deployments. Let me tell you a little bit about TwinGate, and then let me show you just how easily it is to create an EC2 or AWS instance like this, keep it private accessible to you and not public to the whole wide world. TwinGate. It's time to ditch your VPN. You can protect corporate resources, cloud environments, on-prem services, and more with fine-grained access controls based on user, device, and location with TwinGate. They make it easy to implement least privilege principles and require multi-factor authentication, alongside other security policies, even to apps and services that don't naturally support them. With dynamic policies like ephemeral and usage-based access, you can automate a best-in-class security ecosystem. TwinGate offers extensive logging and analytics insights to provide visibility into network activity across the enterprise. System administrators can monitor for suspicious events, trim access to network resources when no longer needed, and get the insights needed for compliance audits. It is seamless to get TwinGate up and running with out-of-the-box integrations with IDPs, MDM EDR, SIEM solutions, and more. You can even automate deployment with Terraform, Pulumi, or their admin API. TwinGate offers a 2-week free trial of their business plan and a completely free plan with up to 5 users for anyone looking to use TwinGate on their own home network. You can get started with TwinGate using my link below in the video description, jh.live/TwinGate. Huge thanks to TwinGate for sponsoring this video. All right, I gotta be honest, I think it's genuinely cool to be able to use infrastructure as code with this setup, like to really have a secure network and environment that you can control and manage super duper easily and spin it all up, deployed and provisioned automatically with Terraform and sprinkling in a little bit of TwinGate. TwinGate has their documentation where you could spin this up with GCP, AWS, and Azure. And just as we had done with AWS, look, it gives you everything that you need to create the connector, a remote network, and the virtual machines. I had gone ahead and created some SSH keys just so I'd have easy capability to access the virtual machines that we create. I set up the Terraform providers in this case, again, keeping it easy, really just need to have TwinGate now included alongside AWS. We set up a new token inside of TwinGate, and that way it knows to communicate and work with this infrastructure. And finally, we could start to set up the real main.tf Terraform file. And this is completely for free, bear in mind, like up to 5 users, you can go ahead and kick the tires, spin this together. Hey, just use Terraform and TwinGate to automatically spin up, create, provision, and deploy this cloud instance that can have whatever least privilege, hey, access controls that you get to define only accessible to you and your team. I think that's pretty cool. You get to see everything that Terraform did, and then of course you can play with it, customize it, make it whatever you want. But now, everything being created, access control set up here, I could go ahead and just SSH into that host, but not exposed to the open internet, and I can get into it, do what I need to do. Best part is, infrastructure as code, all I need to do to tear it down, if I wanted to make something quick and easy, I can just Terraform destroy, and it will bring the house down. Enter a value, yes, I'm ready to take it all offline, and that's all it takes. Hey, thank you so much for watching. I know we really just like scratched the surface. This is like the tip of the iceberg for Terraform, but I hope you go play with it. I hope you give it a try, and please do give some love to our sponsor, TwinGate, link in the video description. They have some really cool stuff, and I love being able to pour in some infrastructure as code along with it. Thanks so much for watching. Do all those YouTube algorithm things, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.